or case study session. So they tried to put the jigsaw together to show us this is the vertical farming, maybe it's in the bigger hole for future. So we're very pleased to invite this Professor Wei Ling Ling. She's from China. So she give talk about China, what the China doing in the plant factory and the open agriculture.
Good afternoon. Thank you for giving me the chance to introduce the plant factory and the urban agriculture in China. This is the outline. Now I will introduce our company. Its name is Ida. Ida belongs to the Chinese Academy of Agriculture Science. We are the leading company in the field of urban agriculture in China. Ida engages in the technique research and promotion, supporting the product development and the design of the agriculture park. The following is the scope of the business. First, the design and the construction of the plant factory. Training and design for the agriculture park. Urban horticulture project. Home gardening. Operation of the National Agriculture Science and the Technology Demonstration Park. Supporting product and the technical service. This coverage in China, we have undertaken over 100 projects throughout the whole country. And now our techniques have been used across the country in excess of 700 times. Constructing international connects with the partners from all over the world. Then this is the key technology of vertical farming, essential in the factory technology. We developed a modern 20 meter layers vertical hydroponic system, greatly improve the space organization. We also, this research case by using the LED light. And then with the environmental control systems, we make the real-time regional observation and the PLC-based intelligent monitoring to the temperature, humidity, light nutrition solution. This is the environmental control system. And we realized the online management and remote monitoring to control the vegetable growth everywhere. This is the mobile phone, laptops, pads, and other terminals through the network transmission system. And then we also do some research in the energy saving environment control technology, LED light, solar engine power, and the plant factory in China. This is the applications of plant factory in China. This is the vegetable plant factories, fruit vegetables and the leafy vegetables. And also we have the breeding plant factories. This is the mushroom plant factory and the herb plant factory. And this is the research plant factories. We used it to do some research just like the LED light. And this is the movable plant factories. We can also use it in the building, in the house, or anywhere. This is the very interesting things. We call the customized plant factories. We have two systems, that's e-garden like this. It has the control systems, and the Android garden, that's like this. Very cute. And also the wall. And then is the applications we made in China. We made a lot of plant factories in China now. First, in CAAS, very small. This is the first one. And then this is the second one. Also, in Changchun, in Jilin province, we drew another plant factory. And this is the Shanghai Expo. This plant factory is in the kitchen. And in Zhuhai and in Nanjing, another. This one is in our demonstration park. It's more big. It's too big, about 1,600 square meters. Now, this is the vision of the future. The hydroponic systems were also used in the greenhouse and then to the plant factories, and also control the vertical farming. Now we talk a little bit about the urban horticulture. IDA was the first company working on the research and the technology promotion in the urban protected horticulture. They used the vertical hydroponic cultivation. Also, we have the vegetable tree, hand potato tree, the greenhouse park, and the eco restaurant, and so on. In the greenhouse park, we use the agricultural mainly vertical hydroponic cultivation, just like this single and multi-layer cultivation of the vegetables, and this DFT hydroponic system, and this is the inclined wall type three demonstration culture. Also a lot of types of hydroponic systems, and this the MFT. We thought because it can be used to suit for both DFT or and NFT. This a type drill cultivars for strawberry, and this for the baby leaf. This the urban horticulture. We thought it potato trees. Hand potato technique innovation. It changed the traditional cultivation mode of the potato. The plant lifespan reaches over 5 years. The yield of the single plant achieved over 1 ton. This is all kind of tree type cultivation. We call this a greenhouse park. Just in the greenhouse, we do a lot of things just like this. Now I can introduce the National Agriculture Science Technology Demonstration Park. This demo park is developed by the Chinese Academy of the Government Science and operated by IDA. For use of the various phytotechnical drones to display the frontiers of the agriculture science and the technology. So we have a lot of greenhouse and plant factories in the park. Our mission is promote the international communication of the high-tech agriculture technology, education of agriculture science, spread the concept of the ecology and the green fashion, improve the strategic position of the national agriculture. Our topic is agriculture technology demonstration and urban horticulture. So our customer just professional field or in the high-end market. Overall, the national level agriculture demo platform. This is the urban horticulture hall in the park. We apply a green ideas to every corner of life. Spread green, health, environmental protect, and the low carbon concept to the whole society. So we include the eco living room, eco kitchen, eco book bar, eco meeting room, and so on. And this is the eco living room. All these systems are home garden system and green innovations, aeroponics growing bed. This is the eco meeting room. We have the green wall, the flower wall, green ceiling, eco meeting desk, and so on. And also we have the eco aquarium with the fish and the vegetables. This is the eco book bar. So we read a lot book and have coffee and some tea in it. This is the eco kitchen. Also, in the kitchen, we have a plant factory, so you can eat some vegetables from it, and you can do it by yourself. Also, a lot of VIP visit our park, just like the Thai province and the other some VIPs. Demo park works as the public education platform for spreading the agricultural knowledge to the local children. This for our CAS and from mainland, from Japan, from Taiwan, and so on. And also I will thank for the our partners, all the partners. Okay, thank you for your attention.
Do you have any proposals to build a full vertical farm? You seem to have done a lot of work there. How far away is a skyscraper?
Well,
in our demo pack, we have two plant factories. We need more than 20 layers of hydroponic system.
Right, so
maybe
right.
In the future, it will become
more funny. About 800 square meters. It's fully installed vertical LEDs. So it's 3,600 LED tubes. 600 is a research module, and 3,000 is for real production module. And then we do the research on the site for strawberries, Chinese herbs, mushrooms even, but only for seedling area. And then we having another 3,000 layers. So get inside, you need to get changed and sanitized. Please use sunglasses, otherwise it's light is very strong.
I just want to try to building,
in the whole building now we have no the plan, but I think in the roof of the building greenhouse park in the roof of the building. Also
the basement.
We will build the factories.
Have you done any economic analyses of the different components that you put up?
For the plant factories, we do, but the vertical farming, not yet.
And what's the time before you start making positive returns? What's the investment actually?
In China, I think about 3 years, the plant factories.
The ladies are growing from now.